Okay, so in today's video, we're going to take a quick look at cross-cancelling when we multiply fractions. So when we cross-cancel when we're multiplying fractions, essentially what we're doing is simplifying them before we carry out the multiplication. So for this first example, I've got 3/5 multiplied by 1/3. So what we do first is look at the individual fractions and see if they're in the simplest form. So I've got 3/5, which I can't simplify any further, and then 1/3, which I also can't simplify. So now we know the individual fractions are in their simplest form. We look across the fractions, numerator to denominator, and see if we've got any highest common factors greater than 1, which we can cancel them down by. So what we do first is we start with this 5 and we go across to the numerator, which is 1. The highest common factor of 5 and 1 is actually 1. So I can't cancel these down. Now looking across the other way, I've got 3 and 3. Well, the highest common factor of 3 and 3 is actually 3 itself. So that means I can divide both of these numbers by 3. So if I do 3 divided by 3, I get 1. So both of these I'm going to change to 1. So now that we've simplified across the fractions, all we need to do is multiply through. So on the numerator I've got 1 times 1, which is 1, and then on the bottom I've got 5 multiplied by 1, which is 5. So now we know this fraction is fully simplified, so 3/5 multiplied by 1/3 is actually equal to 1/5. Okay, for this next question, I've got 2/4 multiplied by 2/3. So checking the individual fractions first, well, we can actually cancel 2/4 down because I can divide top and bottom by 2. So 2/4, if we divide the numerator and denominator by 2, would simply become 1/2, or a half. So 2/4 is equivalent to a half. Now checking the 2/3, 2/3 is in its simplest form, so we can't do anything with that fraction on its own. So now we look across the fractions to see if we can cancel them down. So starting with the 1, I move across to the 3. The highest common factor there is 1, so I can't cancel them down. Then looking the other way, bottom to top, we've got 2 and 2. Well, the highest common factor there is actually 2, so I can divide both of these by 2. So if we do 2 divided by 2, we get 1. So both of these 2s are going to become 1. So now what we need to do is multiply it through. So looking on the top, we've now got 1 times 1, which is 1. And then on the bottom, we've got 1 multiplied by 3, which is 3. So that one fully simplified would be 1/3. Okay, for our next question, we've got 1/2 multiplied by 4/10. Again, looking at the fractions individually, 1/2 is in its simplest form, so we can't cancel that down. Now we've got 4/10, we can actually cancel that down because 4/10 has a highest common factor of 2. So if I divide both of these by 2, I'm going to end up with 2/5. So 4/10 is equivalent to 2/5. So now we've done them individually, we're going to see if we can cross cancel. So starting with the 1, we've got 1 and 5. The highest common factor there is 1, so we can't cancel them down. And then looking the other way, we've got 2 and 2. Well, the highest common factor there is 2, so we can divide both of these by 2. So if I do 2 divided by 2, that's going to give me 1 for both of them. So both of these 2s become 1. Okay, now that we've simplified, we're just going to multiply through. So we've got 1 times 1, which is 1, and then on the bottom, 1 multiplied by 5 gives us 5. So our final answer there would be 1/5. Okay, so for this next question, we've got 3/5 multiplied by 10/33. So again, checking the individual fractions, 3/5 is in its simplest form. And also 10/33 is in its simplest form, so we can't cancel them down individually. So now we're going to look to cross cancel. So starting with the 3, we come across to the 33. So the highest common factor of 3 and 33 is actually 3, meaning I can divide both of these numbers by 3. So if we do 3 divided by 3, that's going to leave us with 1. And if I do 33 divided by 3, that gives me 11. Now we're going to look across the other way. We've now got 5 and 10. Well, the highest common factor of 5 and 10 is 5, so I can divide both of these numbers by 5. If we do 5 divided by 5, that gives us 1. And if we do 10 divided by 5, that gives us 2. So now I've simplified these fractions to 1/1 multiplied by 2/11. So we can see as we multiply them through, we'd simply have 1 multiplied by 2, which is 2, and 1 multiplied by 11, which is 11. So this one fully simplified would be 2/11. Okay, and for this very last question, we've got three fractions which we're multiplying together. We're going to do this exactly the same way as we've done the other questions. We're going to see if we can simplify the individual fractions. Then once we've done that, we're going to see if we can cross cancel. So looking at these individual fractions, we've got 2 over 6. Well, we can simplify that because 2 sixths, we can divide top and bottom both by 2. So 2 divided by 2 would give us 1. And then 6 divided by 2 would give us 3. So 2 sixths is equivalent to a third. 3 over 7 is in its simplest form, so we can't do anything more with that. And 14 over 15 is also in its simplest form. So now we're going to look to cross cancel. So now we've got three fractions. We want to keep checking if there's a highest common factor that we can divide by, which is greater than 1 on the numerator and the denominator. So to start with, I can see a 3 on the bottom here, and then I've got a 3 on top here. So the highest common factor of 3 and 3 is 3 itself. So that means I can divide both of these by 3. Well, if we do 3 divided by 3, that gives us 1. So I can change both of these to 1. Okay, again, we want to look if we can find highest common factors which are greater than 1, which we can cancel these down by. So looking on the numerator, I've got 1, 1, 14. And on the bottom, I've got 1, 7, and 15. So we can see there on the numerator, we've got 14. On the denominator, we've got 7. So we can actually cancel these down as well. Because the highest common factor of 7 and 14 is actually 7, meaning I can divide both of these numbers by 7. So if we do the 7 on the bottom first, 7 divided by 7 would give us 1. And then on the top, if we did 14 divided by 7, that would give us 2. So now we can see on the top, we've got 1, 1, and 2. And then on the bottom, we've got 1, 1, 15. Okay, we can see we've got no highest common factors greater than 1 there. So we can't simplify this any further. So all we're going to do is multiply through. So starting with the top, we've got 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 2, which is just going to give us 2. And then on the bottom, we've got 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 15, which is simply just 15. So our final answer to this question, fully simplified, would just be 2 over 15. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. And I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.